What's going on, guys? How's everybody doing today? I'm doing well. Thank you for asking if I'd be down here. Michael on Tuesday afternoon. Today is deadlift day. I'm also going to incorporate some shoulder presses. Lightweight, you know the reason. But Mike, we want to hear the reason again for the 500th time. I have a bad shoulder, scar tissue, all kind of stuff going on. And it's screwing up on me, so I'm not really putting a lot of effort into my shoulders anymore. So, but we're going to do some lightweight stuff if I can. But the main focus is our deadlifts. What am I going to do today as far as poundages and all that? I'm not sure. I'm just working out. So let's go ahead and start. We got 135 on the bar. You know that's how we roll. Warm-up set. This is important as any set you're going to do in your workout because it sets the foundation. So let's go ahead and get our warm-up set done. I'm actually doing two warm-up sets. So, anywho. So we got some big things going on at the homestead. And if you watched my video from yesterday, you might see a glimpse of something in here that might give some of it away. That's kind of, maybe that'll get you to go watch my video. So you got to look carefully. Let's get our deads going, guys. My hands are already sweating. So I've had a couple of little trolls on my channel over the past 24 hours. One guy talking about my horrible form on my bench pressing, which I've been told by people that have been working out bench pressing professionally for dozens of years, tell me how well at my form and everything is when I bench press. So anytime someone says anything about my bench pressing, I kind of brush it off. Then I had another guy comment on my little quick little video I posted this morning of my breakfast. Fried up some potatoes and onions in the skillet. I had some eggs ready to go. I had a piece of bread with some natural peanut butter on it. And he replied saying how horrible it is and I'm gonna die and everything and all this stuff. And you know, you go check out these channels from these guys. And they either have nothing or they have two videos of them playing video games. So, could my diet be better? Sure, I could be even more strict than what I already am. But I'm not gonna be. There's people that have lived to see 100 years old that have ate eggs, bacon, lard, and other such things every day of their lives. Eggs, all that stuff. So, although we can clean our diets up to some extent, we can't totally clean them up to extreme measures. It's just not, it's not feasible. Most people won't be able to stand that for long. So, if chicken is good for you, which it's considered one of the most healthiest foods, then eggs are good for you because the egg is a liquid chicken. It doesn't matter what they test and the enzymes this and this is different and that it's a chicken. Eat it. Let's do warm-up set number two. Mm-hmm. So, I feel like I'm about ready to cut my hair off. I wanted to experience long hair. And I've had long hair like shoulder length, a little bit longer. But I've never had like long, crazy hair like this. So I wanted to do that and just see how it felt. And just to say I've done it before, you know, in my life. I'm getting to the point where I'm about ready to cut it off. And if you know me for any amount of time, pretty much my adult life, I've kept my head shaved. So, all right, we got 225. Also, you get people that'll comment, and most of the time it's going to be people under 30, boys under 30, talking about how some of us have guts. Well, first and foreskin, I mean foreplay, before, first of all, by the time you reach my age, you're going to have a gut, if not before. Number two, not everybody has the same DNA, structure, metabolism, genetics, all that stuff. Some of us hold weight easier than others. Some people can be skinny and eat all day long and never gain a pound. Some people can sniff some food and gain 10 pounds. That's me. So, what's funny is I know probably 10 times out of 10, not only can I outlift these people, but I can probably outrun these people at my age. short distance, maybe 50 meters or so. Guarantee you I can outrun you. And I'm 250 some odd pounds and going to be 52 this year. So you shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Yeah, we'd all like to look like fitness models. It just ain't going to happen. All right, we got 315, guys. It's the grip, guys. The grip gives out. Ever since I started having problems with those calluses, it's not stopped. So, that's my left hand. So, a question, if you make it this far in the video, question. If I have to use my gloves, to comfort my hands, and I hold them like so, and I grab the bar, do you feel like that's cheating? Do you feel like it's the same as using straps? Or anything else, assisted type lifts, do you put that in the same category? How do you view that? Because that's one thing that keeps me from using them all the time, is I don't want people to look at my video and go, yeah, but you're using gloves. Now, I don't really care so much what people think of me and my videos and how I work out and all that, but at the same time, you know, when you're doing kind of your main lifts, you want them to stand out a little bit. So, just kind of, what's your thought on that? Because I'm probably going to have to use them here in a second. I could probably get this without doing it, without using them, but... One rep. keep in mind this bar number one feels thin. It feels like a thin bar. It's probably not, but it feels thin. And it's thinner definitely than the 6 foot Olympic bar that I have. That bar is a little thicker, a little meatier. I think it's considered maybe a female bar, which is, I don't know why they have different genders attached to stuff, but I think that's considered a female specific bar, but it feels pretty good. So not only does this bar kind of feel thin, but there's zero knurling on it. As you can tell, it's been painted, and I bought it used, and it was, you know, it used and abused and probably left outside, and I don't know. But, I mean, I got tape. That's duct tape you see there where I got markings on it. So, but here's where these are going to come in. Sorry. Gotta rock out some Motley Crue, you know. So we're going to do another set of 405. I'm going to use my gloves this time. My all-time record is 460. And I don't know if I'm going to push myself to do that again for a while or not. I think 405 is a really good point to get to and just kind of keep messing with and working out with. But, you know, who knows? I may put 460 on now in this workout. I never know until I do it. Let's get 405 again. So in yesterday's video, I was talking about kind of being in a funk, and You know, that happens to everyone that does anything, not just working out. But anytime you dedicate yourself to a passion, a love, a hobby, a pastime, whatever, sometimes you get that burnout feeling. And, you know, it won't be long. I'll be hitting 3 years. I've been doing this steady, nonstop. Even when my back is completely out, my gout might be flaring up, my hips might be screwed up, whatever, sick, not feeling good, tired, depressed, all that stuff. I've not stopped, and I've been consistent, persistent about everything I do. So there comes a time, I think, when you kind of hit that wall. And you lose a little bit of that fire, that passion, that drive. And I think some of that with me, in this case, is because I know I've kind of hit my max at a lot of stuff. And that some of the things are being hindered, not only because I've reached kind of my natural potential, but also because of my injury in my arm. So all those things kind of combined, you know, it can put you in a funk. It can put you know, in a frame of mind that you don't want to be in. And if you find that you're in that position, don't stop. Never stop. Just keep pushing forward and do the best you can. Maybe change up your routine a little bit to try and add a little bit of some newness in there. And, you know, but hitting that wall, you know, when you're at your potential, which everybody has a max, you know, you can't just keep going. Everybody has a point. So I think when you hit that point and you notice it, you kind of lose a little bit of that drive. And I think that's what's happened to me because, you know, if I step back and I look at how I am, how I'm coming in here, my mindset, the hours or the days leading up to a certain workout or something, it's not the same as it was a year ago. It's not the same. So, and the answer is not, well, take time off. The answer is not that, because if you take time off, a good chance you won't come back, because this takes discipline. It's an everyday thing. It takes discipline. It's enjoyable, but at the same time, sitting at my desk and playing a video game is enjoyable. So you don't want one thing to overtake the other thing by excuses or laziness. So I don't think taking time off is really the answer in most cases. So just keep driving, keep pushing forward. And having said that, I've rested far too long. I don't ever take that long in between sets. Let's get 405 again. Hopes that my back don't break. Even with the gloves, I'm still getting discomfort. One of my commenters told me a little while back, whenever I grab the bar, try to make sure I overlap my thumb onto my fingers. And although I can do that to some extent, for some reason it feels like it throws my pull off. Giggity. It feels weird. Now, I know maybe it's because I'm not used to doing that, But also maybe it's just my mechanics, I don't know. But I do try to do that. I've noticed periodically I try to do it, and I think once I get up heavier that I don't really do it. But like 135, 225, maybe even 315, I think, you know, along the way I've tried to experiment with it. And it might be a good method. I'm not sure if it's just me or if it's just maybe not for everyone or what have you. But if you're having problems, it was suggested to me to, when you grab, try to overlap your thumb under your fingers. And I guess the pressure is supposed to kind of help with your grip. Don't be dirty about that. So, let's go ahead and do another set of 405. Probably because I just don't feel like lifting up the bar and taking a weight off. So, that's one reason I like doing the elevated deads, is because the plates are like 2 inches off the floor, and it's super easy to just put them on and off. And what I'm thinking of doing is building me like a 2-inch lift to stand on, and that should even everything out, and it would mimic like I'm on the floor, except for I'm on my platform, and it's elevated. So I may do that. And then, you know, I know they got the bar jacks and that, but that's just more cost and something else to have room for, so. All right, let's do another set of 405. We'll talk about why I do this a lot. It's not just because I like dancing. If I remember, I'll kind of discuss why I do that. Let's do 405 again. So I don't forget, the reason that you see me do that, sometimes, even when I'm doing squats, I kind of move my feet around, and I kind of shimmy a little bit, and I might bounce just a hair. That's to try and get my feet to flatten out, and to make sure that they're ready for the workload that's going to happen. It also, it just kind of helps to settle the whole body. But I look at it as a real foot thing, to just get the surface of the foot as wide as you can for as much stability as you can. So that's why I do that. And if you make it this far in, I want to send a special kind of good wishes to another channel, a guy that I follow. His channel is called Big J's Knives. He had kind of a little medical issue over this past weekend or whatever, and he's got to get a little procedure done. I just want to send out best wishes to Big J's Knives, and I hope he gets everything taken care of and gets back feeling good and being strong and getting to enjoy life again. So, everybody, if you would, maybe go over to Big J's Knives. It's literally Big J's Knives. You can find him in my channel subscriber list thing if you need to. But go over there and maybe check him out. He talks about knives, and he'll upload a workout video once in a while. He's a strong guy. He's about 10 years younger than me. But he's pretty awesome, and it's a real good community, the knife community that he's part of. I'm not really into knives, but he commented on one of my videos at some point, I think subscribed to me, and then I eventually checked out his channel, and I reciprocated. I subbed to his channel, and I enjoy just kind of watching some stuff and learning a little bit about knives and different things. And that he can hook you up with some other channels that do the same thing. So, anyway. Set of 405. The first rep's the booger. Whew. So you notice that we are kind of doing a different video format on this, just letting the video go. In hopes that it's still going, let me check. I guess it's still going. So if you've been watching my channel, you know I got rid of some big pieces of my gym equipment. My Titan high-low hack press, leg press machine. I got rid of them. I felt like I was ready to get kind of back to more of the basics. And that doesn't mean that I don't want stuff like that. It's just for right now, kind of where I'm at here, I wanted to get rid of that and just stick to, again, kind of more of the basic stuff. And Thursday, we're going to figure out, we're going to finally see kind of what our next move in life is, what the next thing is that we're doing in our home here. Probably Thursday we're going to see, get some information on some stuff and see what's going on. And then we might talk about what's going on after that. All right, let's do another set of 405. And to end the deadlift part of the workout, we're going to stick with 405. I'm just going to get one more rep deadlifts is really the only exercise I do, the one movement that I do, where I do wish sometimes I had those bumper plates. Not super wide ones, but like some little bit narrower, sleeker, better ones, a little nicer, where they're not like super wide, look like a car tire. Just for the stability of the bar when you got the weights on, you know, you got a wide plate on like that, it's not gonna rack and do stuff. You got these little thin metal plates, it's always wanting to rack over and mess around. I'm not really a fan of all them bumper plates and all that stuff. I think they got their little popularity, I think, from like CrossFit and stuff like that. And now everybody in the world has to have them. All the gyms are going to them. I like hearing some metal, not just music. So we got one more set of 405. Let's end it on a high note. In other words, let's not get hurt. Just end it. Good breath. So, shut the door. The wife just got home. I don't want to hear the dog. The dog's going to go crazy. So, anyway, that's the deadlift portion of this video. I'm not going to worry about showing you the shoulders. I'm not going to do anything extraordinary. But, yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video and got a little something out of it. Maybe a little conversation starter. Off in there. I also want to bring up another YouTuber, Bad Body Not So Fit. He's had some comments about him as well, and his weight and how he looks and different things. And I just want to say he's amazing. He does great stuff. He does a lot of body weight type stuff, things that blow your mind. And plus, he has a really bad left shoulder and arm. It's a nerve kind of thing. It's almost dead. Not really, but it might as well be. And he does some really great stuff. And again, we're not all going to have six packs and looking like a romance novel cover. But it's getting out there and trying and doing your best and being the best you can be within reason and still enjoying life and doing things that you enjoy. So, if you get a little something out of this video, guys, a little inspiration, a little fire under your butt, like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff to the Body Beatdown. That's me, Michael, your incredible host on this Taco Tuesday. And don't forget, get up, get out of your rat, do it to it. We'll see you next time on the Body Beatdown. See y'all later.
Get up, get out, get rad, and do it, do it!